Bring your own energy today, baby. I need all that energy today, baby. All day, baby. Woo! Can we turn the volume up out here or what, man? Come on. This is as loud as it gets. From the first snap, we're dominating. I got two in a row. All day. Go Blue! Hey! Protect!
Get action. Here it comes near side. Hartman, 20, 15, 10, explodes. Touchdown, Kansas City.
That's big time, boy. Who's that?
The Jet 36. Chiefs lead 7-3. Mahomes guns it long for the end zone. Wide open touchdown to Tyreek Hill. And the Chiefs get two touchdowns on as many drives.
Hey, I think we should talk about how no fans came to touch Tyreek. That's good protocol. That's Chiefs Kingdom, baby. Great protocol. I just love this Travis Kelce.
Did you draw the goatee or did you try to just
reconnect? This is a roundhouse kick. No, this is pretty much the same, huh? Maybe like a hair or two right here in the connection part. Pretty much the same, though. Dude, it's just, it looks like a little, it's pencil drawn. A little pencil draw.
Well, he's got to buy next week to get the goatee right if he's worried about that. Can cover it with a mask out there a little bit today as he gets set for the Panthers at home. Guys, I know this sounds ridiculous to say. It's just a feeling, right? It's not necessarily based on facts or statistics, just a feeling. Does it feel to anyone else like the Chiefs are a little bit under the radar this year?
Not just the Chiefs, Sam. It's Patrick Mahomes. Like, he's getting left out of the MVP talk. You hear, like, other games will be on, it'll be national TV, and his name somehow gets left out. We are taking this guy for granted. 21 touchdowns, one interception so far this year. He's got a better QBR this year than he did in his MVP run in 2018. Watching this guy play, it baffles me that we don't talk about him more. Yeah, quite honestly.
Go ahead, Brew.
This is just what defending Super Bowl champions want to do, to tell you the truth. To give you the best chance to repeat, is just slide up in there. Nah, nobody talk about us until Thanksgiving comes around. Because then when Thanksgiving comes around, it's like, whoa, are the Chiefs still at the top? Is Mahomes now, wait a second, he's only throwing, what, one, two picks, and he's got all these touchdowns. Wait, there's MVP candidate right there. There's a team that should be favored to the Super Bowl. That's the best team in the league. That's exactly what you want to do. Just sneak up on them, just like they're doing. It's working out perfect for the Chiefs to make a strong run in about a month.
See, Bruce, some of us had never been in that situation.
That's fair.
I was defending Super Bowl once, but I had enough of you guys. But anyway, I'm looking at this, man. Today, I think Carolina has a chance in this game. And the reason I say it, remember when I said the formula to me is win runs and completions, and you have to win the turnover battle. Teddy Two Gloves, all right, I've always been hard on him, but he doesn't turn the football over. And Randy, you already talked about it. He's second in the league in percentage throwing. Staying ahead of the sticks. Yeah, he's dink and dunk, but you stay ahead of the sticks. You keep Pat Mahomes in this offense on the sideline. And that's how you do. You got to pick up those third downs. You get Christian McCaffrey back. And as good as Kansas City is, man, nobody can stop this guy. So to me, I think they have a legitimate chance in this game.
You know, and speaking of that, you know, me being able to reside down there in Charlotte, North Carolina, the city is in the uproar, but in a positive way about new head coach, getting Christian McCaffrey back. But I think when I look at this game with the Carolina Panthers being on the road, last year, the Kansas City Chiefs won the Super Bowl. Matt Rhule was at college coaching for Baylor. And now he's coming up less than a year, and his biggest game this season is halfway through the season against the defending Super Bowl champions. You're talking about the way to keep Patrick Mahomes on that sideline. Mike Davis, Christian McCaffrey, led by Teddy Bridgewater, to be able to move that ball up and down that field. But there's one part of the football field that the Carolina Panthers got to get better in. And that's in the red zone. They got to be able to put some points up in the red zone because Patrick Mahomes and them, regardless of how they stumble, they still find ways to put points up on that board. This is a big game for Coach Matt Rhule.
The tough thing for Kansas City defensively is they don't really know what they're getting, right? Yeah. Like, they've seen this Mike Davis. They've seen this, you know, what Teddy Bridgewater's doing. But now you're adding Christian McCaffrey to the mix.
Yeah, yeah.
And Adam even said it kind of, you know, it made me, like, perk up my eyes a little bit. Like, wait, what did you just say? Perk up my ears a little bit. Like, you're saying you're adding Christian McCaffrey to Mike Davis's role. Like, what? So I think defending these guys, we could see a two running back set. I think it's sometimes tougher for a defense to go in. You're game planning against kind of the unknown.
Yeah.
And that's a dangerous spot.
I mean, we're talking about the Carolina Panthers here, right? Because I hear you guys talking. It's like we're talking about the Steelers or something. We're talking about a team that can compete with the Chiefs because
we're talking crazy.
I think we're talking crazy. I don't think they have a chance because dink and dunk all you want up and down the field. This is a defense that can't get off the field on third down, and you can't get to the passer. So if I'm Mahomes now, so you're telling me I get to sit back there, you can't get to me, and I can just do this all game long. Mahomes, we're going to be talking about Mahomes tomorrow, about another leader in the MVP. He's going to get them 3 touchdowns, Sam, to put him to 100. He may get 4. He may get another 5 because his defense is young. They've got a couple veteran players, yes. But this man right here is about to go off on a team that's still learning what Matt Rhule wants to do and a defense that's young and hasn't seen anything what like they're about to see at the quarterback position, in my opinion.
Yeah, well, look,
I agree. You're right.
I agree with that.
Betty's right. Let's just be honest, though, some of this
is he's just a victim of his own success. The expectations are so high that when you see he threw 4 touchdowns and didn't throw a pick in a game, it's like, oh, yeah, it's Patrick Mahomes, no big deal. Part of it also, though, is they haven't had as many, like, big primetime games. The schedule, they have a bye next week, and then they have 4 NFC South teams. They're going to have some bigger games down the stretch where I'm sure we'll be talking about the Chiefs plenty throughout the show. Now let's get back to our insiders for some news this morning. Morton, Adam, what do you got?
Well, thanks very much, Sam. Welcome to the Domino's pregame headquarters. Antonio Brown is expected to make his debut for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers tonight, but he also still has an ongoing civil suit that is expected to be heard next month, set for trial regarding exploitation, sexual assault, about a woman friend of his that he used to know. The civic trial, again, is set for December 14th. The next hearing date is November 25th. The NFL is waiting to see what happens. The process has moved along very slowly in the opinion of the opposing attorney at this point in time. But again, that is ongoing, even though Antonio Brown is back for the Buccaneers tonight. More.
And Adam, as you know, the Raiders have been the first team to lose a sixth rounder taken away by the league for brazen and repeated violations of COVID-19 protocols. $500,000 fine to the team, which owner Mark Davis calls draconian. Another $150,000 to coach John Gruden. And that brings their tab up to almost $1.2 million for violations deemed by the league. Mark Davis is going to appeal this to the league on the $500,000 sanction.
Mort, the NFL is coming up one of the busiest weeks of COVID. It had 10 teams put either a player or a staffer on the reserve COVID-19 list. You see Trent Brown going back on the list. Marlon Humphrey will not play today for the Baltimore Ravens. Chris Jones was close contact, but he is expected to play. And Baker Mayfield added to the list this morning, though he did not test positive, and he could be eligible to return to practice later this week, assuming he does test negative. And Matthew Stafford did clear his test this morning. He is expected to start against the Vikings, Mort.
And as we go into this week, the NFL's lost no games because of COVID-19, and they're determined to push through the full 256-game schedule. But the competition committee did meet on Monday and voted to present a resolution to owners that if games are lost before Week 17 and a Week 18 is not practical for those makeup games, to expand the playoffs from 14 teams to 16 teams. There would be no bye weeks. You'd have the division winners 1 through 4 and 4 wild card teams, and that they would be seeded that way by winning percentage, Sam.
All right, thanks, guys. I know you'll keep us posted on that. Meanwhile, Ryan Tannehill and the 5-2 Titans at home against Nick Foles and the Bears. Both teams have lost 2 straight, so who gets it turned around?